Hi, I'm Uriel, and welcome to the MIT App Inventor Sketch and Guess video tutorials. In this three-part tutorial, we'll be going through how to make the app Sketch and Guess. Sketch and Guess is a game of two or more players where you'll be able to have one sketcher who sketches on their screen. And for the other players, that sketch will update live on their own screens, and the guessers will have to guess what is being drawn. When the correct answer is reached, there's a notification that says that they won the game, and then you can start over with a different sketcher and guesser and try to draw a different object. To do this, you'll be using lots of cool components, such as the canvas, which will allow you to draw, and also CloudDB, which is the multiplayer component of App Inventor. This will allow for the transfer of information between different devices, and it does this via the cloud. Now let me show you a quick demo of what the Sketch and Guess completed app will actually look like by the time that we finish these tutorials. This is an image of the screens of the completed Sketch and Guess app. I have two devices here because it's a multiplayer game. That way I can demonstrate everything that's going on. As you can see, the first screen that shows up immediately upon startup is just a choice of whether you want to be the sketcher or the guesser. So say I want to be the sketcher, I'm going to press I want to draw. If I want to be the guesser, I'm going to press I want to guess. You can see that this brings us to two different screens. The sketcher has a canvas where you can actually draw on it and make tons of images. And this is immediately translated over. Here, let me show it live. There you go. It immediately updates. You can also press the clear button and it'll clear on both screens. Now, the way that the game works is that the sketcher will press new picture and it will say exactly what they should be drawing from a set of options. So here it says draw a sun. So as the sketcher starts drawing what they've been told to, the guesser needs to guess what it is from a drop-down menu. You can see that there's tons of options. If the guesser guesses incorrectly, say a video game, it's going to say, oh no, try again. But if they do guess correctly, say it's a sun, it says, that's right, good job. And it's also updated here, saying that the game has been completed. Now, to make this whole tutorial, we're going to have to set up everything first. So to do that, we're going to first set up the functionalities of these buttons and move in between the start screen, the sketcher screen, and the guesser screen. Let's get started. Now, to get started, go ahead and go into the description of this video and download the Sketch and Guess template AIA file. Once you've downloaded it, go ahead and go to ai2.appinventor.mit.edu, this site, and go to My Projects, Import Project from My Computer. Click on it and go ahead and choose the file that you just downloaded to your computer, and then press OK. Once you've done that, the template file should open automatically. Okay, so here we are in the Sketch and Guess template. Let's have a quick tour around and look at the components. You'll probably recognize a bunch of these from the demo that I just showed you. So this is the opening screen, screen one. And it has just really two buttons, a sketching button and a guessing button. And these will bring you to two different screens. We haven't coded the functionality yet, but when you press the sketcher button that says you'll want to draw, you go to the sketcher screen up here. And here is where you would draw if you were the sketcher of the group. There's an option to start up a new picture, an option to clear what you've already drawn, and an option to go back to the previous screen. We also have some non-visible components, namely CloudDB, which will be taking care of the multiplayer component so that the phone of the sketcher and guesser can communicate, and a notifier that lets you know if you're being correct with your guesses or not. There's also the canvas, which is the part of the screen that you can actually draw on with your finger. Now, if instead you chose to be the guesser, you would go to the guesser screen. Let's go to it now.
Here you also have the CloudDB and the notifier as non-visible components. That way you can use the multiplayer component and see whether you're correct with your guess. We have the canvas, which lets you again draw. And then we have the special component, which is a spinner, which is basically a menu of choices, which lets you pick what you think the sketcher is drawing. And of course we have our back button, which brings you back to the selection screen. If we go back to screen one, then we can get started with the blocks. Always make sure that you're in the right screen when you're doing the blocks. You can check up here. If you're in the wrong screen, then the blocks will belong to the different screen and won't activate the way that you want. To go to blocks, let's click on the button in the upper right-hand corner. So since we're in screen one, we just have the two buttons, which bring you to the two screens. So let's code that now. Let's click on Sketcher button and do when Sketcher button dot click. Well, when the Sketcher button is clicked, we want to go to the sketching screen. To change screens, go to the control drawer and go ahead and do open another screen. Here you have the option to put in the name of the screen that you want to navigate to. You do that by just writing it in as the form of text. Text box is at the very top. The screen name that we want is, you can check here, the Sketcher screen. Make sure that it's spelled exactly as you set it up in the screens. Okay, now I'm sure you can guess what we need to do when the guesser button is clicked. We want to go to the guesser screen. Again, this one. We can just duplicate by right-clicking and pressing duplicate, and then changing this to when guesser button is clicked, and set the text to guesser screen. Great, now we've set the functionality for the two buttons on screen one. Let's set the functionality for the back buttons in each of the two Sketcher and Guesser screens. Let's click on Sketcher first. And the back button, well, what we want to do is go back to the original screen one. So let's go and do back button and do when back button dot click. Now, we're going to again want to change screens, but the way that screens open is that what we did in screen one, when it opens another screen, it will open Sketcher screen on top of screen one. So all we have to do is close the screen we're currently on, Sketcher screen, and the screen one will still be open below it. So we can go to control, and just do close screen. This will close the Sketcher screen and reveal the screen one behind it. And we'll do the same thing for guesser. When back button dot click, close screen. Okay, this would be a good time to test this out with the MIT AI2 companion. Test that you can click I want to draw and I want to guess to open the correct screen, and that it returns to screen one when the back button is pressed. To do this, first make sure that you're in the screen one, not the guesser screen. I like to go back to the designer, click on the screen one, and make sure that I see these two buttons. This is because when you connect your app to test it, it will open up on this whatever screen is open right now. So you don't want to start in one of the interior guesser sketcher screens, you want to start here, at the beginning. Make sure that you do this every time you connect or later build your app. It's very important for the app to work correctly. Then go ahead and scroll up to connect and click AI Companion to scan a QR code with the Companion app. If you don't have this app, you can use the emulator to run it on your own machine. I'll show you what it looks like now.
All right, so this is what your screen should look like right now. Here we are in screen one. So let's try pressing the I want to draw button. As you can see, it's brought us to the Sketcher screen, where it has the options to draw. We haven't set that up yet, So let's just try out the back button right here. Again, back at screen one. Same thing for guests. It's all set up and we go back and we're back at the screen. Make sure your navigation works and then we can go on.
Now that you've set the functionality of the traversal buttons, let's set up the drawing section. To do this, let's go to the Sketcher screen because that's where the drawing will actually be happening. And let's make it so that when you drag your finger across the canvas, a line will appear. That way you can draw on the actual screen. The first thing that you're going to need to do is go into the canvas drawer and do whenCanvas1.dragged. So this triggers when you drag your finger across the canvas, the way that you might draw on a touchscreen. And now what you have to do is go to Canvas again and do canvas1.drawLine. Because the way that drawing on this canvas works is that it makes a bunch of tiny little lines with every movement that your finger makes. And these lines are so tiny that they end up looking like the nice curves. And these lines have starting point x1, y1 and endpoint x2, y2, which will be very close to each other. So for x1 and y1, you're going to need previous x and previous y. Just hover over them and drag them in. The reason you're going to want these is that these are the latest x and y coordinates that the canvas has gotten from the data of your finger dragging across it. These are the ones that it has seen just, you know, half a second ago. The ones that it currently sees are current x and current y, and that's why these will be the endpoints. Again, hover and drag them in. This will make it so that you can draw on the canvas with your finger. The last thing that we need for the actual drawing part is to set up the clear button. The clear button is what you'll need to do if you want to actually clear everything that you've drawn and set the canvas to its normal blank white state. So go ahead and go to whenClearButton.click. And when the button is clicked, well, you want to clear the canvas. There's a block for that in Canvas. Call canvas1.clear. And there we go. That should set up the drawing functionality. Go ahead and test your app again. Make sure that you can get onto the Sketcher screen and draw all over it, and then press the clear button to clear the canvas.
Okay, so now that you've implemented the drawing part, let's go ahead and click on I want to draw and test it out. So drag your finger across the screen and you can see that it leaves the pen marks behind. So you can draw anything that you like, and if you don't like it, then press clear and it goes away. Draw, clear. There we go. That's how it should work. This concludes part one of the Sketch and Guess tutorial videos. Please join me for part two, where we'll be setting up the CloudDB and making sure that two different devices can communicate to set up this multiplayer component. Thank you.